It's me again. In this episode, I'll talk about something that I personally overlooked before, but recently I've had much more interest in and found much more in-depth tuning option for the car, and that is anti-roll bars. So the very basic principle of anti-roll bars is once the car would roll, it will take load off of the inside tire and place it onto the outside tire. In this way, it will have more force on the outside tire and then on having less roll in the car. So you could really think of it as a spring for roll. If you think of shock springs as springs for how the car moves up and down, think of anti-roll bars as a spring for how the car moves side to side. But as a basic principle, think of it as placing weight from the inside to the outside of the car, and you will have more maximum grip on the car. But if you go too stiff on the roll bar, you will exceed the grip on the surface and you will obviously lose grip on the car. So you will really have to find the edge of the grip here. But having the right anti-roll bar stiffness for you will really help you gain the maximum grip on the car. So on track, the differences between a thinner and a thicker roll bar are quite clear, and you will really need to sort of figure out the very basics first, as I just explained. And now we'll go through how a thicker roll bar will affect your car on the track. So as we already said, as the very name tells you, having a stiffer anti-roll bar will result in less roll on the car. Having the weight transfer from the inside tire to the outside tire will reduce the roll motion in the car and put that force on the tire on the outside, and a stiffer bar will just advance this motion. So if your car is really rolling around and you really needed to stiffen it up, a thicker roll bar will help you. On the downside though, the car will become much more stiffer, and that will result in the car being much more nervous. So having a little rut on the track, your car will not be rolling over the rut, it'll be pushing more force on the outside tire, which would have a sort of a similar effect as a higher roll center, as you would see in the roll center episodes where I talk about this issue, driving over ruts with the higher roll center. Now, having a more nervous car can be good as well if your car is too lazy to begin with. Having a stiffer front roll bar will make the front end more precise, so it will make your front end go sort of where you steer it. It will not have the front end sort of move around and roll around as freely, but you will have the front end more precise. The car will sort of follow your directions more, and overall you can really sort of gain trust to the car by doing this if your car isn't too nervous to begin with. What comes with less roll and having more force on the outer tire, you will most likely have better corner speed as well. So having that preciseness, having that stiffness in the car will gain you corner speed because the car won't have to roll and the car will be less sort of lazy and all over the place with a stiffer roll bar. Something I personally always felt, especially in the rear end of the car, having a stiffer roll bar really, really makes the car handle worse over bumps. So having a really bumpy track in the rear, especially when you were sliding the car around, it really makes you hit the bumps a lot harder with the stiffer roll bar. And most likely having a really soft roll bar on super bumpy tracks is really going to help you out, and you will just need to try to find other ways to make the rear end sort of stand up and not roll around as much. But having a stiff roll bar in the rear on a super bumpy track most likely will give you a really hard time. In the front end, having a stiffer roll bar on a bumpy track will most likely not help you, but it won't have as big an effect as too stiff of a rear roll bar would have. The way I found it, I always want to go on a thinner roll bar in the rear on a bumpier track. Now, we sort of gone through the pros and the cons here, but everything sort of has to be put into perspective. If you're starting from a really nervous car and you put a stiff roll bar into it, most likely you're going to make the car just even more nervous. If you're starting from a really lazy car, having a stiff roll bar will make the car less lazy, so you're sort of gaining there. If your car is really on the edge of the grip and you will and you really already have a high roll center or stiff springs, having a stiff roll bar will most likely just make the car tip over the edge and make it too stiff overall and you will lose grip. But if your car is really soft overall, you have a low roll center, you have thin springs, having a stiffer roll bar will make the car sort of stiffer, you will have more force on the outer tire, you will gain grip and gain corner speed. But this all has to be put into perspective and find where you are already in the setup. Now, what then comes to having thinner roll bars, it's pretty much all of the opposite. So the car will be more lazy, the car will have more roll, you'll be better over bumps. In the front end, it will make the car less precise but more sort of free. So you can, if you like to drive really loose and sort of have more open lines, this probably won't hurt you. But if you're really precise with your driving style, having a too thin of a roll bar in the front might actually make your life a bit harder. It's pretty much sort of, you need to find a balance between having a too thin or a too stiff roll bar. And one thing you really need to remember is everything affects this. So having a higher roll center or a lower roll center, or having stiffer or thinner springs, having more angle on your shocks or less angle on your shocks, all of this affects how the car will roll, and the anti-roll bars are just a part of it. You will need to think about all of it together. You will need to think about what type of springs you're running. You will need to think what type of roll center you're running. And you will need to think, hey, what do I really want from the car? Does your car feel like, for example, in the front end feels stiff under braking, but in the corner it feels like it rolls quite a lot. Maybe you need to go to a thinner spring, but a stiffer roll bar. So sort of find what type of movement will you need to spring in the car. Will you need more movement on the shocks? Will you need more movement on the roll? What type of thing you need? What type of thing you really want from the car? And anti-roll bars is a really, really good tool to tune the roll of the car and tune how and when you will have the most grip on the roll. So it's sort of a it's sort of an extra tool to tune with your roll center movement. Sort of like the springs are with your anti-geometries, the roll bar is with your roll center. One final thing about the roll bars is they have a pretty big connection with some of the topics I've talked about in the last few episodes. The wheelbase and the friction in the drive shafts. So, for example, if you would have the rear hub much more forwards, you will feel like the car will want to squat and sort of squat to one side once you exit a corner and go on power. And then on, you will need to compensate for this with a much stiffer roll bar. Then on, if you move the rear hubs backwards, you will see that your car isn't rolling much and it's not squatting much once you accelerate. And then you would see that you could go to a thinner rear roll bar. This is also something you need to take into account on top of how your roll centers and springs work. So one thing I've personally noticed is that you can have a very sort of different type of setup and reach a very similar end result. For example, by having the rear hubs forward and a really stiff roll bar, or the rear hubs backward and a thin roll bar. Both of these setups have their benefits and their downsides. The car will overall feel similar, but in certain scenarios, other one is the better. For example, having a longer wheelbase in the rear and having a thinner roll bar will most likely help you a lot over bumps. And then on, having a stiffer roll bar and a shorter wheelbase in the rear will most likely help you on a slower speed track where you need to accelerate and get the car to turn around the corners as fast as possible. So this is something that also need to keep in mind, and I feel like anti-roll bars are very easy to change when you're at the track. It's very easy to tune with them, and you can really feel the difference most of the time. So this is why I really enjoy them. Alright, so I hope you liked the episode. As I already said in the start of the episode, I recently really like to tune the car with roll bars, and I find they're a very good tuning option, and an easy one at that. And if you checked a few previous episodes, you will probably realize that all of these sort of connect together. So hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time. Alright, I hope you liked that video. If indeed I did actually help you out, please let me know by writing a comment down below. Also, if you like my type of content, feel free to like my Facebook page as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also share it with your friends in social media. Now, if you think I was wrong about something in this video, please let me know. I'll go through all the comments, and I'm really open to differing opinions, and I really want to just spark up a conversation. So, with all that, until next time.